When I was at home, I was down on my luck. I earned a good living by drawing a truck. But old aunt died and left me a thousand oh. I'll start on my travels, says Billy Barlow. Oh dear, lackaday oh, so off to Australia came Billy Barlow. When to Sydney I got there a merchant I met, who said he would teach me a fortune to get. He'd cattle and sheep past the colony's bounds, which he sold with the station for my £1,000. Oh dear, lackaday oh, he gammoned the cash out of Billy Barlow. When the bargain was struck and the money was paid, he said, my dear fellow, your fortune is made. I can furnish supplies for the station, you know, and your bill is sufficient, good Mr. Barlow. Oh dear, lackaday oh, a gentleman settler was Billy Barlow. So I got my supplies and I gave him my bill, and for New England started my pockets to fill. But my bush rangers met with my traps they made free, took my horse and left Billy bailed up to a tree. Oh dear, lackaday oh, I shall die of starvation, thought Billy Barlow. At last I got loose and I walked on my way. A constable came up and to me did say, are you free, says I, yes to be sure, don't you know. And I handed my card, Mr. William Barlow. Oh dear, lackaday oh, he said that's all gammon to Billy Barlow. Then he put me on the handcuffs and brought me away, right back down to Maitland before Mr. Day. When I said I was fine, why the JP replied, I must send you down to be identified. Oh dear, lackaday oh, to Sydney once more went Billy Barlow. They at last let me go and I then did repair for my station once more, and at length I got there. But a few days before, the blacks, you must know, had speared all the cattle of Billy Barlow. Oh dear, lackaday oh, it's a beautiful country, said Billy Barlow. For 9 months before, no rain there had been, so the devil a blade of grass could be seen. And one third of my wethers, the scab they had got, and the other two thirds just died of the rot. Oh dear, lackaday oh, I shall soon be a settler, said Billy Barlow. And the matter to mend, now my bill was near due, so I wrote to my friend and just asked to renew. He replied he was sorry he couldn't, because the bill had been passed to a usurer's clause. Oh dear, lackaday oh, but perhaps he'll renew it, said Billy Barlow. I applied to renew, he was still quite content, if secured and allowed 300%. But as I couldn't do, but Rogers and Co. soon sent up a summons for Billy Barlow. Oh dear, lack-a-day-o. They soon settled the business of Billy Barlow. For a month or 6 weeks I stewed over my loss, and a tall man rode up one day on a horse. He asked, "Don't you know me?" I answered him, "No." "Why, my name is Kingsmill, how are you, Barlow?" Oh dear, lack-a-day-o, he'd got a fi-fi for poor Billy Barlow. What I left of my sheep and my traps he did seize, and he said they won't pay all the cost of my fees. He then sold off the lot, and I'm sure it was a sin, at sixpence a head and the station given in. To England, said Billy Barlow. My sheep being sold and my money all gone, I wandered about then quite sad and forlorn. How I managed to live, it would shock you to know, and as thin as a lathe got Billy Barlow. Oh dear, lack-a-day-o, quite down on his luck was Billy Barlow. And in a few weeks more the sheriff, you see, sent the tall man on horseback once more unto me, having got all he could by the writ of fi-fa. By way of a change he'd bought a casa. Oh dear, lack-a-day-o, he seized on the body of Billy Barlow. He took me to Sydney and there he did lock poor unfortunate Billy fast under the clock. And to get myself out I was forced, you must know, to schedule to fine of poor Billy Barlow. Oh dear, lack-a-day-o, in the list of insolvents was Billy Barlow. Once more I got free, but in poverty's toil, no cattle for salting, no sheep for to boil. I can't get a job, though to any I stoop, if it's only the making of portable soup. Oh dear, lack-a-day-o, pray give some employment to Billy Barlow. There's still a speck left, may have me on my stumps, if a wife I could get with a few of the dumps. So if any lass here has 10,000 or so, she can just drop a line addressed Mr. Barlow. Oh dear, lack-a-day-o, the angel shall be Mrs. William Barlow.